What's up, y'all? What's up, y'all? It's Solace checking in with the fam. Happy New Year to all of y'all. Hope y'all got some good goals set up for the year. Hope all the things that you got planned come to fruition. Same for me. You know, I've had a lot of like good things planned over the years, and just through growth and trying to like find myself and like figure things out, I haven't like been accomplishing a lot of the goals that I wanted to do. But that's going to change. 2023, we got a lot of good stuff planned. I finally figured out like what I see for UA going forward. We have a new album coming, Homecoming, which I'm excited about. That's 100% coming. It's going to be a mix of all the stuff that we like. But what I've noticed with music and hip hop is that there's been like a resurgence of hip hop. Like the kids in Atlanta are doing a good job. And in New York, they're doing a good job. California do a good job. But there's not like this specific sound. Like I always think of like Waves by Joey Badass. It's like my favorite Joey Badass song. And like that sound is kind of missing in a sense. I'm not trying to like bring back some old shit, but just that vein of just music in a sense is missing. So trying to like hit those targets and like of course come with like the bangers as well. And then after that, the plan is to do Lord of the Flatbush 4, which I'm really excited about. And hopefully doing it with the twins or whoever. But that's gonna be really fun to do. Bunch of bangers. And really hoping to go on tour this year. And yeah, see you guys again. Have fun again on stage. But yeah, being independent is it's hard, but it's fun at the same time, but it's hard because it's kind of just all in-house. So there's not like this big engine that's just like controlling everything and like kind of adding structure to like the freelance existence of like an artist. So it gets hard to kind of like keep up with everything. And yeah, but it's fun, and we're in a good position right now for this year. It's a lot of good things going on. Pressure I'm working on, but I'm kind of working on the underachiever thing kind of harder right now. But pressure is going to be put out with the label, and they're going to help me like get it really, really good. But that's going to be like, I want to say like the best shit that I'm going to try and do. I mean, underachiever, of course, but I mean for Issa Gold, like it's, and I'm probably going to use the name Solace. But yeah, it's 10 years of Indigoism too, so that's gonna be cool. Gonna do a bunch of Indigoism center like stuff for the year and like for the tour that I could talk about later, but I don't want to talk about too much because I don't want to fucking say shit that like doesn't happen, you know. I'm being overly ambitious, sorry to you guys for that. But it's Indigoism year, so it's a good year for like just bringing back just that UA feel and sound and touring and just interviews and things of that sort. So really excited about that. Really excited to tour this year and see you guys. Homecoming is going to be an interesting project. And I'm excited because when's the last time? I feel like we haven't dropped a song in so long. I think it's 4 years since the last album, which is just insane. And we've done a lot of growing because I think people forget, including me, like we're growing with you guys. Like a lot of you guys started with us from 16 to 18, and now we're all older, and a lot of things change and a lot of things evolve. And like, it's unfortunate that like early on in our career, we presented like image of perfection when we were still kids and growing and trying to figure it out. And obviously that had positive effects on like how our music came out and how it like interacted with you guys. But in the same breath, it created a delusion of like perfection and like, that's why here on Tempest I'm being a lot more vulnerable and a lot more transparent and a lot more identifiable with like real life struggles that we still all go through, you know, from depression to addiction to freaking whatever. Thank God I'm not on hard stuff, but weed, you know, sucks. We all fucking smoke pot and like, but I love it though, and that's great. But Lord of the Flatbush 4 is gonna be incredible too. I can't wait for that one. I plan to do it with King Jet and Shuiz as the producers, but we'll see what happens. But yeah, just want to remind you guys that we're not perfect and we're figuring it out and we're growing up, and any mistakes that I've made to you guys, I apologize sincerely because I was just young and like I might have said, I'm going to do this, or we're going to do that, or do this. And I'm sorry that I like drifted into the background. In a sense, it's just I was growing and learning and identifying like who I am in music, because I've always had imposter syndrome. And I probably spoke about this, but I always will speak about it in the sense of like, I didn't see myself as becoming a musician my whole life. That just like kind of fell in my lap. I was AK's manager originally, and you guys probably heard this story in probably another podcast. But so through this whole time of being a musician and being talented at it and having all these other traits that people see as like valuable in an artist, it was hard for me to accept that I'm good enough. It's still hard for me, and I'm very pessimistic and very self-judging, and I'm trying to work through that. But yeah, hope to just keep like growing, and I'm in a good headspace now for music and UA and touring and social media and all that type of stuff. But yeah, I'm sorry for any mistakes that I've made before to you guys, you know. And yeah, text me if anything, 917-774-1721. I've been answering as many guys as I can, but I'm still mad people to get to. But yeah, text me anything and I'll try and talk to you guys and go back to the FaceTime and stuff. But yeah, I love you guys. It was a short check-in. Hope everything is good over there. Happy New Year's. Hope you got some new resolutions and some new situations in your life that can bring some positive shit in there. And yeah, love you guys. Hopefully new single next month. Well, new single next month, but I don't know when. That's 100%. Not lying to you guys. 100% new UA single next month. Don't know when. I'm pretty sure I know which song it is. It's called Smoke and Waters. But yeah, I love you guys. Text me, hit me up, however. And yeah, cheers to a new year. There's a few vinyls left on the site. I'm gonna probably drop a 10% for everyone here in the podcast for a day on everything that's on there on overlandhills.com. There's CDs left, there's a few hoodies left, and there's t-shirts left. Yeah, I'm gonna get them made as soon as the store closes and get them out to you guys ASAP. Thanks for your patience with us. It's just me doing everything. And yeah, love you guys. And you'll hear from me soon.